were dropped against the unarmed man shot by police in early December. KOAT Action 7 News reporter Laura Terrain joins us live from Metro Court to tell us why the judge is now pointing the finger at APD.
Royal, it's because the judge said that police took too long to decide whether Shane Sherrill had committed a crime. See, Sherrill was shot and then arrested on December 1st, but it wasn't until January 23rd that a criminal complaint was filed, and that was just too long, said the judge. Shane Sherrill didn't look his best while appearing before a judge Friday. He was in a wheelchair, his leg and arm both in a cast, his demeanor slow and confused.
Now, what you need to do is talk to your lawyer, sir.
For the past month and a half, Sherrill has been under police supervision at the University of New Mexico Hospital, recovering from a police-involved shooting when officers fired multiple rounds into his body. Bullets that collapsed his lung, ruptured his spleen, and broke his arm and leg. Sherrill was shot here near the corner of Northeastern in Wyoming on December 1st, and police say they thought he had a gun on him. This still picture, taken from an officer's lapel camera, shows Sherrill moments before he was shot.
If you notice, Shane Sherrill is in a shooting position, his hands raised to about eye level as if he's pointing downrange.
But APD Chief Alan Banks says it turned out Sherrill was only pretending to have a gun, using a knife, a brake pad, or both to fend off police when they approached him after a 911 call about a domestic violence incident. It took police more than a month after the shooting to charge Sherrill with aggravated assault on a police officer with a deadly weapon.
We need to begin with State of New Mexico versus Shane Sherrill.
On Friday, Judge Linda Rogers told Sherrill and his lawyer because police took so long.
It is my determination, sir, that the 48-hour rule for probable cause determination has been violated.
And Sherrill's aggravated assault charge is now dismissed. Now, just because that charge was dropped doesn't mean that Sherrill is off the hook. He could still be indicted on that charge, and he remains behind bars tonight because of charges stemming from an entirely different incident. Live in downtown, Laura Terrain, KOAT Action 7 News.
We also spoke to Sherrill's attorney, who says he is filing a lawsuit against the city. Joe Kennedy says police have refused to release the lapel camera, which he believes will prove his client did not assault the officers in any way.